verses 14 through 21. And the specific scripture reading from Numbers, chapter 21, verses 4 through 9. I will be reading from the New Revised Standard Version Bible. Please listen to these holy words. From God. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up. That whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God is sure of the word, that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Those who believe in him are not condemned, but those who do not believe are considered already condemned, because they have not believed in the name of the one that came out. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and people love darkness rather than light, because they do not work in it. For all who do the work of the light, and do not come to the light, so that their deeds may not be exposed. But those who do what is true come to the light, so that it may clearly be seen that their deeds have been done in God. Now for members. For now, of course, they sent out by way to the Red Sea, to go around the land and do it. But the people became consistent on the way. The people spoke against God and against Moses. Why have you brought us all out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? Because there is no food and no water, and we did trespass the miserable food. Then the Lord sent poisonous serpents among the people, and they bit the people, so that many of the Israelites died. The people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned by speaking against the Lord and against you. Pray to the Lord to take away the serpents from us." Then Moses prayed for the people, and the Lord said to Moses, "Make a poisonous serpent and set it on a pole, and everyone who is bitten shall be judged and delivered." So Moses made a serpent of bronze and put it upon a pole. Whenever a serpent bit someone, this person will look at the serpent of bronze and live. Holy reading for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Thank you so much, Claudia, for reading those scriptures today. I knew I wanted to have three scriptures this morning, but I was worried about getting three scriptures for the liturgies, and then I thought, fun, and I knew we would be in different. So just keep those coming out. I was wondering if my heroes are just stuck in the stage. Hopefully that didn't happen. Well, good morning! Is it morning? Is it afternoon? Is it the middle of the night? I don't know anymore. We seem to be doing this time change thing. I no longer know why. But here we are. I think it's around 10:30. You may have other ideas, but I think it is time for us to get into the Word this morning. I want to tell this story that I grew up in the dark. My mother was just terrified of light. I don't know if any of you grew up in a similar fashion, but we had a lamp on our kitchen table. So, like, just absolutely pink overhead lights were not allowed to be turned on in my home. Can you think I've grown up this way? This is really a strange thing. I thought so. I thought it was weird. But my mom is just like a very low light kind of person. It's funny because our kitchen was yellow, like canary yellow, but under the low light, it was very moody. It's funny because I thought that that design was not what I thought because I grew up in that. Like when I was a teenager, I used to turn on a fluorescent overhead light in our kitchen all the time, just like bother. But if you've been to my office, I don't ever turn on overhead light. It really created a new existence that I really love, and there's hiding. And it's funny because these days I'm starting to notice how important lighting is. Lighting is important for our mood, it's important for we take on different like skin tone, depending on the light that we're in. Georgia, as our senior older than yesterday, and I thought this was so funny that one of the images immediately back in the photographer said, which you like these classes in a warm light or a cool light. It's interesting because you see you are going to sell that out before you get the pieces. Now you can choose afterwards and you can have them in both. The filters that we can now put over photography images is incredible. We can change and affect the light. Even if that lighting is not present at the time. I know about you, but I love filters. It's a little program called Snap Effect. If you are older than the age of 40 in the room, you may not know what that is, and that's okay. Don't be done with it. You don't need it. But I don't actually use the program except for the features. So you can put these little filters on your photos and like turn your hair pink. Some people do not have pink hair, but you love putting the Snapchat filter. You can put turkey caps on your head or actual caps on your head. You can be really silly. You can take one photo of the piece of that whole from our first day of kindergarten. Kindergarten is rough. Kindergarten is rough for the age for 100 years, that very first day. You can apparently make a 6-year-old look like she's 105. It's really funny. You can put different filters on your pictures. Now we know that these are all fake. We know that these are not real. It's just not really what my 6-year-old looks like. And my kids don't walk around with hats on their heads. But sometimes there's other filters that we don't know if somebody's using them or not. But there's pictures now that you can just take all the blender face, lay it up on your face up. Automatically, you have wrinkles. It's kind of great, right? You have a nice little glow like me, and you haven't seen the beach in years. But you can filter all these little slight changes, and you don't really know whether to filter or not. And I think the interesting part is, I think that we started to kind of live our faith in this way too. Yes, we're not fully pretending like we're something that we're not, right? But in some slight ways, we do put on a different ways. And we just kind of cover up just a little flaw. And the only problem is, it takes to help you to put a picture on your picture so you don't have wrinkles and cut. That's fine. Anyway. But the problem is, that if we are only looking at those images and we fully start to believe that that is reality, now we can wrinkle together. I can pretend that in place is much fun. But when it comes to filters of our things, where we pretend like we're not saying, I'll pray for you, but we're really just going to believe that we're going to pray for you. You see other little filters? Start to play a role in our faith. We say we're going to church the system and we're going to be disciplined, and maybe we do for a couple of days. And then we just go through the other things. We start to put on little tiny pictures that make us feel like we are faithful to passing through the Christ. And I think these pictures are starting to change my understanding of this text in John's Gospel. You see, when I originally read this text years and years and years ago, when it was worth not that, I used to believe that this text was not for me. Did you hear some of the words that it says? I'm talking about this idea that those who love the darkness, who are just in time in the darkness, are those who love evil. Right? I wasn't thinking that we love evil. But even as a teenager, I don't think they liked evil. So I don't think that the scripture was talking about me. But in this structuring age, I started to think about it. When it talks about those who choose to live in the light, allow the light to expose their truth. Now, even at the age of 41 in my faith, I don't need y'all coming close. With a fluorescent flash. And I think about the lighting in hospitals. Nobody's taking their senior photos in the emergency room, actually. The lighting is so bright And it's done for a purpose today. It helps the doctors and the nurses see the tiniest things, the tiniest little things that might happen to them. They're able to see and determine all the things that they need to see. They want your body to be exposed that they might be able to help you, to be able to heal you in the tiniest little ways that you might be wounded. We don't really need lights when we get something after the other song. I have to turn the lights down here because it's just so bright. And I like it a little bit better with some little bit of lighting and it makes me feel more comfortable. Back in so many ways, we like to share our faith with the end of the evening and twilight light, where we can show out our best features. And this is where I'm understanding that John's gospel is talking about what it is for those who are the truest of disciples who yearn to live and expose the hospital floor of their life so that all of their deeds might be uncovered as those done for God and by life. This is a faith that I'm not sure that I have yet. So interesting that this scripture recalls an Old Testament story. But we get some of the variations on the gospel. It says, as the serpent of Moses has lifted up the serpent, so too must the Son of Man be lifted up. This is a recalling back to the Numbers text, which Claudia also read for us. Now, why I think this has something to do with each other is that the Israelites were trying to cover up their grumbling and their sin. Remember that? And here they are in prison. They don't like the food. They're hot. Why did they come to Egypt just to be brought into the wilderness to die? Right? They're just complaining to their sins. And what's happening is, isn't it a sin to complain? No, it's not a sin to complain. But the problem was is that he had a filter over their complaints, and the filter over their complaints is that they are not recognizing that the complaining is taking over their lives. Right? The way that they are complaining is that they're not finding happiness in doing things, but they're not even recognizing that the man of the world is holy. Others are yearning for the meat pots and needles. And so they're missing the very presence of God because their complaining has now been trapped and hardened their hearts. That is how complaining turns into sin. And so what happens is that something real weird, they can smell it, that there's filth on the scene, and start to bite people, and then the people start dying. So while the thing wasn't really interfering with my life, I thought. Now I'm not convincing that I'm in trouble and I'll do this place. I don't want to be bitten by one of these snakes and say, people like to go to Jesus and they say, pray for us, find out what God is doing, help us, we are dying. And so I'm stuck here into a whole weird snake on a stick and hold it up. And the next time somebody gets bit by one of the snakes, you look in the eyes of the snake and the stitch, it's very weird. The thing will be healed automatically. Does that imagery of the snake on a stick, does that stick in your mind a little bit? Right? The rod on the previous, is that right? On the previous. And here's the doctor, which is a little known to wrong. It's one thing I pronounce it for you. Right, so this is also the Greek god who was over healing and restoration, right? And so the medical field adopted their symbol. But it's kind of interesting because it seems a lot like the symbol that Methodist, which in the Numbers, is also a whole set. Now, these wouldn't have been the studies then, so I'm not trying to make a parallel, but I just think it's interesting. And I think it brings to me some type of revelation. Jesus doesn't want to kill clearly people who are in darkness, right? That's what John's gospel says. Did not come to shine the bright light on you if you continue to show you just how dirty and wrinkled you really are again. But Jesus came to shine the light so that you might be healed. script before I left it. Right? And I'm sleeping in real quick on how that goes to work. So I go to bed on time and get up on time and work. How do I spend my spare time? And then the last question was, which is the love of the heart of the lesson, which inspired me so much. Is Christ real to me? I'm giving you these questions as a mid-March and late. I'm giving some things to first week and late, 6 weeks and 2 minutes. But I'm giving them to you 3 weeks before Easter. I'm just coaching you real quick. What might happen if we just lay this next project in for 3 weeks and just go through those 22 questions and focus? Maybe if you want to trip one, just fun sticker, you might as well want your answers. But how might this start to transform us? I'm thinking a lot about this week. And one of the things I started to recognize, we love a good challenge in 2024. We love a good transformational story. In fact, in so many ways, I think that we as people probably challenge ourselves more in 2024 than maybe we ever have before. But what I started to see when I looked at sort of like advertisements for transformational jobs, like sometimes you want to be different. And what comes up that you can buy in your hand, you're one of the first things that comes up, right? And what was so interesting to me, don't go over your work because it's just, you know, means you're adopted. But every single one of us has to see the picture of what really happened. They always bring you the final picture. Look at what you did. They want to inspire you. They want to inspire you with what your life could look like. And guess what? We're right next to it. It's not going to be hard. It's real easy. You don't have to work the things the way that you do, and you don't have to go through them. Are there feeling jobs? Yeah. But I looked up another egg from one of the treasuries of transformation, the elderly woman. It's a program called the 12 Steps. And this is the only ad that I could find. I never saw an ad that showed a really happy, healthy, perfect person. All of the ads talked about the problem. Because what's the first step? Admitting that there is a problem. And so each of these ads talked about, are you ready? Have you had enough? And then it said, you won't have to do it all. You won't have to do the right. Not one of those other elements promised to be done. That's what you wouldn't do. You see, church, I'm so convinced when I look at Christian advertising that we are in the best church. I'm so convinced. We just are inspirational. You can look like Jesus was one more bicep. Sign up for the 6 week study, and you will be the disciple of Jesus. You will look just like this. It's a prayer board that you can make. If you can have a Jesus view prayer board and put it up on your wall, prayer will now be enjoyable. It's so simple, it's so easy, three simple steps, and you will become the disciple of Christ that you want to be. Not hard at all. I think the walk of faith is a lot more like John's life. It's a lot more like a ship. In fact, I don't even think we've just went through walk in discipleship until we can admit that there's a problem. As much as I want to do, but I've got it all figured out. filter so that you see only the holiness in you. And we don't even get to the next eleven steps. And so what kind of gospel and number that is seven is the church. Are you ready to walk into the light? The heart's light. The hospital exposing light. Are you willing to ask yourself this hard 22 questions each and every day that you might uncover that there's been a wound that you didn't know it for a really long time? Not so that you can sit and self-pity. You know that that's what the question is. This is not the reason for the light. The reason for the light is that wound. And what I love most about John Wesley is that he was in love with grace. Grace between grace and grace. But I don't understand what doctors can do and how grateful I am for them until my life gets saved. Our world will never understand it until we recognize how it is. Thank you so much for this day. We thank you for the light. We thank you that you would invite us into that. God, that though is very scary. For some of us who have been so long, could get moved like it and feel good like that. So, might you take our food in this morning? Might you walk us to your next into your heart? May your presence of comfort overwhelm us, could we begin to ask the question? What are we doing with our time? Are we turning back and looking at it? And we allow the scriptures time to live in and take them. To be whole of us, to a higher standard, and therefore worth than our faith. God, as we begin to do things, this space of overwhelming light, and we start to uncover places where maybe we thought we had it figured out, but really we don't. God, might you remind us that there is nothing we can do to fill up our own wounds. But the healing and the repentance took place by your Son thousands of years ago on our earth. And it is only through your grace and forgiveness to walk into the understanding and the freedom of being transformed, created